On this week's Xamarin Show, I have my good friend Jim back on, talking about object detection with custom vision AI, Xamarin, and awesome toys. Yay! Tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and today I have my good friend Jim back. How's it going, Jim?
Good, good. How are you?
I'm doing absolutely lovely. It's a beautiful, sunshiny day in Seattle, like every day, so you know I'm in a great mood.
Excellent. Yeah. Excellent.
You're all the way in from?
I'm all the way in from London.
That's well, right. I never know where you're at, because you're everywhere.
I am everywhere. Yeah. Yeah. Now, all the way in from the UK, still a little bit jet lagged, but really excited to be here.
Yeah, so you're
doing some great stuff.
Cloud developer advocate, correct?
Yeah, cloud developer advocate. My specialism is Xamarin.
Nice.
I'm all about the Xamarin. So my job is to build cool Xamarin stuff, help developers get on board with Xamarin, help developers build cool things, create some samples, great content for people, show them how easy it is to build amazing apps, and take advantage of some of the services we have with things like Azure.
Yeah, and you were on a little bit ago, and you were here with toys, and you're here back with more toys.
Back with more toys.
More toys, gotta
have toys. Gotta have the toys, yep.
And last time you were showing us kind of how you built a way of taking photos of your daughter's toys, correct, and identifying them. So like this is BB-8, or this is a monkey, right?
Yep.
Kind of like the hot dog or not, but even more advanced, because you're identifying a bunch of different things.
Yes.
But you're back to kind of tell us about an evolution of that service we talk about today.
Yeah, so today I want to talk about the new hotness of
new
this.
Hotness.
We did have a new hotness. So the thing I showed off about 6 months ago, I assume we'll have a link in the notes underneath this.
Down there.
Yeah, so the thing I showed off was image classification, where you have this idea of transfer learning. Got we it. Have these neural networks built by very, very smart people. Mm-hmm. Not me, smart people.
Not me.
And you give them 5-10 pictures, and you say, this is a hot dog, this is a not hot dog, this is banana, this is an apple, and it trains a model. And then you can upload a picture and it will give you the percentage confidence that that picture is a picture of the hot dog or the
Got
not
it.
Hot dog.
Got it.
Now, that's really cool. But the next evolution of this, which we now have as part of our custom vision service as a preview at the moment, is object detection.
Okay, so object detection.
Yes.
What's the difference? Because it sounds similar.
It kind of is. The difference is when you have image classification is you take a picture of a thing and it says it is a thing.
Yes. Thing A is thing A.
With object detection, you train it up on lots of pictures of things and then you take a picture that could contain multiple things and it says this is thing A here and thing B here.
Got
so
it.
Not only does it say it is the thing, it actually shows you, it tells you where the thing is on the picture.
That's very nifty. You could use that in all sorts of different scenarios, I'm imagining, especially if you're taking in images, doing content filtering, or searching for just certain things, such as, I remember the story of someone using kind of these things to do cucumbers that were coming down a line, and they were detecting good cucumbers versus bad cucumbers and different ratios, but now they can see where it's at inside that photo.
Yes. See which you could take a photograph of 10 cucumbers and see where it is.
So, or a cucumber and a carrot.
A cucumber and a carrot.
And then it would tell you both of them.
Yes. Well, actually, a really good real-world use case for this is we have our Seeing AI app that's been built to help visually impaired people. Phenomenal piece of work. And that does currency detection. So if you imagine, you could train this up on £5 notes, £10 notes, $1 bill, $10 bills. You lay out some money on a table.
Got it.
You take a photograph with it and it can say, right, I think there's a $1 bill, a $1 bill, a $10 bill. You have got $12.
Got it.
So you actually can add up how much currency you've got. And Seeing AI does that for about 5 or 6 different currencies at the moment, but you could build a similar thing with this.
Cool.
Obviously, I'm doing it with cuddly toys because I think they're a bit more fun.
I do love cuddly toys. Well, where do we get started? Where do we do?
So the place to get started is customvision.ai. And here we go, customvision.ai. Cool. It's our portal for training these models. It's pretty much free to get started. You can build a whole lot of models for free. And we love free, don't we? Everyone loves free.
Free is good.
So you come in here, you create a new project. And what we saw last time was you could create a classification with a domain. This time there's now this object detection preview option.
Yes, this
is new.
You can
create a model. So this is the new hotness.
Got it.
Now I'm going to use a project I've already created because these models need a bit more data. With image classification, you need 5 or 6 pictures as a minimum. With object detection, you need about 15 pictures.
Total or per
object?
Got it.
And you can't just give it the pictures, you have to tell it what's in the picture. So for example, I've got one here of probably my daughter's most favorite toy. She calls it Baby Mamo, because naming, she's a bit of a programmer when it comes to naming. She's not so great at it. And in this picture, I uploaded it, and then as you can see, I drew this bounding box to say that this object is Baby Mamo, this part of the picture here.
Got it.
So I focused in deep on the object. And it means if I had a picture with, say, two, I could then tag both in the same image.
So you drew those boxes, or?
Yes, I do those boxes. So I'll show you now. I can click Add Image, and then I can choose an image here.
Cute.
And this will then add this image. I upload the image. I don't tag it in line. I upload the images first.
Got it.
And then I can find the untagged images. And I can go in here, and I just, it's gonna try and detect something. So I'll let it choose that, but then I'll adjust the box myself.
Whoa, this is cool.
I'll bring it in nice and tight for the object that I want. And then I say this is baby polar bear.
How important is that accuracy right there? Is it? You said you're going to get nice and tight. Is that really important in this kind of detection?
Yes, because otherwise it could pick up noise from around the image.
Got it.
So if I were to leave this as quite a big board around here, it may not be good at detecting the polar bear. It may be very good at detecting things sitting on top of an orange chair.
I see.
So I want to bring it in quite tight. I also should really consider rotation.
Mm.
So this trains the polar bear being the right way up. But of course, if I take a photograph of the polar bear
upside down,
it won't detect it. So ideally, I should try and take lots of pictures in different rotations. But for now, I'll just do it right way up.
Sure.
And that's it. I just do that. And then because of my zoom, it's fallen off the bottom of the screen. Let me just zoom out. It's not going to do it. Okay. It's done it. Cool. It's accepted.
Auto save
on that one. Let's ramp the zoom up a little bit. Cool. And then when I do that, I can just click the train button, and that will then retrain my model using that data.
Okay.
I won't click train now because this one's a little bit slower.
Okay.
With the image classification, it trains like 20, 30 seconds. This sometimes takes a couple of minutes. Mm. And you don't want to see us sit here waiting for it to train.
Got it.
For a couple of minutes. So that's how I create it. And I've got a whole lot of tagged images in here. Mm. I've got 30 of baby duck, which is the duck here, 23 of the cat, 29 of monkey, and then 43 of the polar bear. So again, it's not that much data that I have to put in.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fairly dull drawing all these boxes, but once it's done once, it's done.
We're good.
All done. Now, if I wanted to test this, I can then, the same as we saw with the image classifier, I can either give it an image URL or I can upload an image.
Oh, so you take any image that you have anywhere and then boom, it's up there.
So this is one I took on the channel line desk just now.
Right here.
And there we go. Whoa. So we've got baby monkey with 84.8%. And baby polar bear, 93.5%.
And it even gives you the probabilities down here of its guess.
Yeah, and we have a probability threshold. So you can adjust the threshold on this quick test here, because obviously you may get something that it thinks it's X, thinks it's Y.
Yeah.
I created a model for currency detection, and I wasn't very good with my bounding boxes.
Mm.
So it actually detected with low probability £10 note, and then £10 note slightly offset, and £10 note slightly offset,
because it
picked up some background data. So you need to kind of adjust these thresholds to see.
Got it.
But that's the quick test. So this has got it there, and it's detected the objects.
Yeah.
And you can see by these red boxes, we have the actual location there.
Yeah, that's really cool. And you can even see like there's stuff in the background, but it's ignoring it. It's really focused in. That's really cool.
Yeah.
So how do I get it into the app, I guess?
So this is what's really cool, is you get this into the app exactly the same way you got the image classification into the app.
Yeah.
Literally, it is the same API call.
Got it.
I mean, literally. So there's the NuGet package, the Microsoft Azure Cognitive Services Vision, Custom Vision Prediction NuGet package.
Short and sweet.
Short and sweet. Straight to the point.
It's really, you know, we're really about declarative names, so you know exactly what you're getting, and this could not be more verbose. It's very nice.
But it is nice, because this is the Azure Cognitive Services, it's the vision part of it, and obviously we have speech, and under vision we've got face, we've got custom vision, so
that's good.
You know, it does make sense.
That's good.
And we've got prediction and training.
Yeah.
So the training you do in the portal, you can also train from a NuGet package as well if you wanted to.
Very cool.
So you could take that training on the road, as it were.
Got it.
So I could actually train from my phone if I wanted to.
Nice.
Now, I will just highlight, this is currently preview.
Mm-hmm.
This package is version 0.10.0 preview. So if you use this, don't forget to tick the use preview packages option.
Got it.
So we bring this package in. I create a new thing called a prediction endpoint, and I pass this a prediction key. Obviously, I'm not going to show my key. This is a key that is owned by you. This is the key you get from the portal.
Oh, okay. So that came from the portal
in
here.
Yeah.
And so, you just grabbed it.
Yes, so I can click on settings, I'll see my key. There's two keys you get. There's a prediction key and a training key. So of course I could put the prediction key in my app to predict and the training key in a training app if I was building two different apps there.
Got it.
And there's also a project ID because I have multiple projects. Each have the same prediction key but different project IDs,
okay.
Which allows you to then maybe build up multiple different models that you can access from the same app.
Got it.
Which is pretty good. So I create my prediction endpoint with my prediction key. I take my photo. I'm using the Xam Media plugin, which is really simple to use. It's, you know, one line of code to take a photo. And then I call predict image. I pass it in my project ID. I pass it in my stream. And that spits back predictions.
OK, so what is it? What is a prediction?
So a prediction is a combination of the tag, so the name that I've got, baby polar bear, baby monkey.
OK.
It is the probability. Mm-hmm. The amount at which it was seen. So if I just flip back here to the, when we try it, let's bring that quick test back up. Again, it's the probability, which is the figure that pops up in just 1 second. There you go. So I get back this tag, I get back the probability.
Is it going to be returning all of your tags or just?
Yes.
So for
the custom vision one, it returns all your tags. For the object detection, it returns all the tags for the ones that it finds.
Oh, okay.
So if you think we're seeing two tags here, whereas I've trained this for four tags.
Got it.
The duck, the cat, the monkey, and the polar bear. I'm just getting the two because that's all that's detected. Uh-huh. I'm getting those probabilities.
Oh, okay.
And as well, I'll also get the bounding box, which comes as a percentage distance across the image. So this is kind of about halfway. So I'll get bounding box that starts like 0.5, 0.2, and it's got a width of 0.4 and a height of 0.8 or something like that.
So if you wanted to end up having like some cropping image thing, you could then use that information to crop out the image.
Yes.
Cool.
Yeah. So that's pretty much all I do to call it. I then filter out my predictions based off a probability of, in my case, I'm using 75% because I don't want to pick up some.
Because you care about whatever's the most highest predictions, and if there's none that are above 75%, they should probably take another photo, I guess.
Yeah, I'm assuming those are probably errors. I could obviously adjust that to suit based on my criteria, but I'm assuming those are errors.
Cool.
And that's literally all I do. And then I've put this into an app. I've put in some Skearsharp code to actually draw the bounding boxes on screen. So should we try it out?
Yeah, sure, let's do it.
Let's do it.
So you've added those nuggets into both the .NET standard and your iOS and Android app, right?
Yes.
So you install it everywhere.
Yep. Install install all the thing everywhere.
Install all the things everywhere. That's right. Got it.
Yep. And there's no initialization to do. All my code is run inside the .NET standard project. I don't have to do a blah 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 dot init inside my iOS or Android app. It all happens in .NET standard.
And this is literally it. Prediction endpoint, predict images async. That's literally all of the code.
Literally it.
Wow.
That's it.
Very impressive.
So I make my call, create my endpoint.
Boom.
And then that will just do a standard Android launchy thing, and in a minute we'll see my app.
Ah. Oh, so cool. Threshold.
This is my app, yeah. So let's take a photo, and I'll do my best photographer. Let's line up the monkeys without a monkey in the background. There we go.
Cool.
I'll take this photo. And then it's going to send this photo. It's going to send it up to the cloud. And then it's going to make this prediction. So let me stick another breakpoint there.
Yeah.
This then makes the prediction, takes my project ID, my photo as a raw stream, does its thing. The very first time you make the call, it's a bit slow, and then repeated calls get quicker because it kind of loads the model up into whatever infrastructure behind the scenes. And then when you stop your app and restart it. Cool. Okay, so it's made the call, it's taken the photo, send it up the custom vision service, it's run it through its neural networks, and it's brought back all the predictions.
Cool.
So we can see these results here. And let me just zoom in a bit. So it's picked up. There's a 1% chance there's baby duck somewhere in the image.
I don't see a duck here, though, so it makes sense.
Yep, there's no duck. And what else have we got? We've got a 4% chance that there's the duck somewhere else. So you notice the duck was there twice.
Because there's two of them that it detected.
Yeah, so with the bounding box, there's a bounding box here, 0.40, 0.3, 0.4. That's where it thinks baby duck was.
Ah, cool.
And if I then have a look at the other one, the bounding box for this one, 0.4, 0.4, 0.3, 0.5. So maybe it thinks that the polar bear possibly could be the duck, and maybe the monkey could be the duck at a very low percentage.
Got it.
And then so on, we've got the different baby mamow, the cat, 2%, 5% for the cat. It's probably not the cat. Let's see if we've got further down here. Any of these? There we go, 87% for the polar bear. And then let's see if we've got the monkey anywhere. 71% for the monkey.
Pretty good.
Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good. So I've got a threshold of 75%, so it's probably not going to pick, well, it won't pick the monkey up this time around. But I run this through, and then as you can see here.
Ah, very cool.
What it's done, it's detected the polar bear, and it's given me back the coordinates of where the polar bear is. Now, the monkey, it said 71%. I set my threshold to 75. I could then obviously adjust my threshold down. Let's bring it down to 58%, for example. I take a photo.
To the studio live in action.
Yeah. See it happening. And then I run that through. Let's go and make the call. Should hopefully be slightly quicker the second time. Maybe a little bit quicker.
There we go.
But again, let's just run this and see what appears on screen. And this time, nope.
Still didn't get it.
Still didn't get the monkey. Slightly different bounding box, I think, on the polar bear.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, though. The different detection, probably based on the angle that you took it, that was there. And that seems like kind of makes some sense. And there's also some background noise that probably wasn't introduced previously.
Yeah, and it could be if I kind of swap the two over, I might get a different result because of the background noise. Yeah. But these things, just like with the custom vision service, these images will then feed back up.
Ah.
So here's all the ones that I used before.
Got it.
So here we have the studio shot.
Oh.
There we go. Baby monkey 54%.
So close to put it, what, 58?
58%, yeah, and it came back at 54%.
Very cool.
But of course, I can actually take this and say, well, actually, let me just tweak the bounding box. Your bounding box is not quite right. And that's the polar bear. And then I can do the same on this one. I can then tweak the bounding box. It's actually pretty good on this one.
Yeah, that's actually really close. Yeah. So you can kind of constantly improve the detection algorithm here based on the actual photos that you're taking.
Yes. Very cool. I can keep retraining my model. I can then click train again, wait a couple of minutes for it to finish training, and then I take the photograph, and next time it would have taken into consideration the color of the desk, the studio lighting, and probably give me a better result. And I can do that for all the shots that I've taken.
Now, one question for you really quick. I know in the other image classification, there was like a Core ML model and a TensorFlow model. Is that something in this, or is it completely different?
In theory, you can create those models. Mm-hmm. You can create TensorFlow and Core ML object detection models. Mm-hmm. We don't have that available from the Custom Vision service at the moment.
Got it.
I have no idea whether they're planning to do that or not. I can't comment on that.
Yeah, the question is, like, does Core ML even support that, I guess?
Potentially, yes.
Yeah. Oh,
yes, okay. You can build those models.
Got it, okay.
But we don't have that capability at the moment. So
cool.
I'm hoping one day we do.
Got it.
But I don't know.
Have you come back and show us how to export Core ML and TensorFlow in?
It would literally be the same as with the image classifier. It'd literally be I click the export button, I get the model, I run Core ML.
So very cool. And you can just do this all today at Custom Vision AI.
Custom Vision AI, you can do it all today. You can do it as part of the free trial.
Very cool.
So this will not cost you anything. You get so many thousand calls. I don't know the exact numbers, but it's so many thousand calls, so many hundred images you can use to train it with. And yes, you can get going. Head to customvision.ai and you can just get going now.
Cool.
With this.
And can people get the source code? Can we put that up on the GitHubs, or what's the plan there?
This source code is up on the GitHubs. We'll stick a link
in the show notes,
to get the source code for this. And yeah, you can build the app. You can just plumb in your own IDs, put in your own prediction key, your own project ID for your models, take a photograph, and it will show you where on the image your photo actually is.
Very
so
cool.
All that will be in the source code.
Awesome, Jim, I love it. I like kind of like the next evolution of taking it a bit further, and I really like the drawing of the boxes on there. Very cool.
It's very cool.
Awesome.
I can't wait to see what I'll be doing here 6 months' time with the next evolution after this.
Exactly. Well, thanks for coming back on and showing us all this new hotness.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. You can find all the links in the show notes below. Don't forget to rate, subscribe, ding that bell to become a member of the notification squad so you get the Xamarin Show right in your inbox each and every week. Until next time, I'm Jace Montemagno. This is the Xamarin Show, and thanks for watching.